Children, let us revise lesson 5, the magpie's lesson from textbook and activity book also. After that, let us revise unit 3, 4 and 5 from the grammar book. Let's get started now. And our lesson is the magpie's lesson. See, magpies are found in America. These are sociable birds who love brightly colored objects which they often do steal from people's garden. Many years ago, one bird in the whole world knew how to build a nest. That is magpie. All birds went to the magpie and begged to teach them how to build nest. It started building nest by using few techniques to protect itself and its little ones. When the magpie started building its nest, in the half of the process only, each bird flew away and started building their nest by using their own thoughts and needs. Now, let us know how the birds have built their nest. First of all, eagle. Eagle built its nest on the highest cliff of mountain. Lark and bobolink built their nest in the meadow. Meadow means what, you know? Tell me, children. Into the tall grass of the meadow. After that, Oriole hung her nest down little twigs. But Whippoorwill hasn't made a nest and laid her eggs in a hollow in the ground or in the log. Owl has planned to lay her eggs in a old crow's nest or a hawk's old nest. After that, robins and crows built their nest without the dome. But swallows built their nest on building, often under a roof or a window ledge. Others have made their under roofs of open barns and still others under eaves. But still the magpie builds her nest at the top of a high tree. And which things it's use? And which things it will use, children? Mud, sticks, and covers it with a dome to make comfortable and cozy. So, this is the first bird which knew how to build a nest and thought to other birds how to make a nest. Okay, children, I hope you understood the lesson. When I have revised to make you understand this lesson. Okay, children, now we have revised the lesson 5. Now let us get into the exercises. Children, in this exercise, we have to take the correct answers from the options. Are you ready, children? See here. The eagle flew away because it, here options are, was bored, wanted to build its nest on top of a cliff, or was too proud. Which is the correct answer, children? Tell me. See, the eagle flew away because it wanted to build its nest on top of a cliff. So only the eagle flew away. After that, the oriole decided to build its nest where? Tell me, children. Of course, in a tree. After that, the whippoorwill is called lazy bird because it never makes a nest. The next one. An owl lays its egg. Where it lays, Nana? Tell me. Of course, in a crow's old nest. The robin decided to follow the magpie's follow the magpie's instructions? Or builds its nest, build its nest in a hollow. Which is the correct option here? Of course, the robin decided to cover its babies with its twigs, with its wings. Okay, now let us get into the important exercise. In this exercise, here they have given common expressions related to the birds and we have matched them together here, and after that we have filled these blanks by using the same themes. After that, we have circled the words which are connected to the birds in this word search. See here, birds related words are claw, nest, feathers, bird, eggs, wings, beak, flight. So these are the words which are connected to the birds. Now let us get into the next exercise. In this exercise, we should fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets. Before filling these blanks, we have to learn few grammar points which belongs to the pronouns. See children, words such as I, me, he, she, it and them, which are used in place of nouns, are called pronouns. We use pronouns to avoid repeating words, right? This also makes it easier to understand what we say and write. Okay, children? And in the same manner, we have to learn about possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns are used in place of possessive nouns. They tell us that something belongs to somebody. Now, let us learn few words which are based on possessive nouns. Mine, yours, his, hers, ours and theirs. In the place of which words we are using? I, me is becoming mine. He, his. She, hers. Theirs, them will become theirs. So, how it is turning into the possessive nouns, you have to observe. Okay. Now, let us discuss about this exercise and let us fill these blanks with the correct words which they have provided in the brackets. These shoes are mine or me? Of course, it belongs to me. And how it will become as a possessive noun? Of course, mine. Let us check the next one. Dash can't tie the shoelaces. Could you help Dash? Here we are using I. I can't tie the shoelaces. Could you help me? In the same manner, let us check the next one. Dash are going to the park. Do you want to come with Dash? We are going to the park. Do you want to come with us? Let us check the next one. No, that ball is not Dash, it is Dash. Here they have given the options mine and me. Here, hers and her. Which is the suitable word here? Of course, mine here and hers here. In the same manner, you have to practice the remaining also. Let us get into the next exercise. In this exercise, we should replace the underlined words with pronouns. Now, we have finished them in the correct manner by using the correct pronouns. See here, Tom is buying apples. Here, we replace the words with the correct pronouns. See here, he is buying them from the store. In the same manner, we have completed the remaining also. Now, let us get into the next one. From the activity book, I have given a passage and we have to read and understand the story of the elephant and we have to tick the correct answers from the exercises. After finishing that exercise, we have completed true or falses which belongs to the same passage. After that, we have completed few exercises from the word wise. For example, see here children, many expressions use comparisons with animals to describe human quality. See here, for example, as timid as a mouse. In the same manner, we have completed the remaining also. After that, we have to find the common names of 10 birds in this word search, and we should write them in the blanks. And we should write them on the blanks. In the same manner, they have given one example here. We have completed this exercise also as a homework. Now let us get into the next one. After that, we have completed to circle the correctly spelled word in each set. After that, we have seen a picture. See here. After observing this picture, we have completed few fill in the blanks from the exercise. Now let us get into the next one. From the book of grammar and more. In this, we have to revise now three topics. Chapter 3, verb. Chapter 4, articles. Chapter 5, pronouns. Now let's get started this book also. Our chapter 3 is verbs. See, verbs. Words that name actions are called verbs. A sentence always has a verb. Verbs tell us that a person, an animal, or a thing does or did. Most verbs are doing verbs. Okay, children? Words such as is, are, am, were, was, has, have, and had are also verbs. They tell us what someone or something has or is. These words can also be used along with a doing verb. Now let's get started to the exercises. In this exercise, we should fill the blanks with suitable verbs. You may use one or two verbs each sentence. See here, please dash your room. Here we filled with clean. Please clean your room. In the same manner, Achal dashed his friends in the park. Achal met his friends in the park. The school bell dash at 8 o'clock in the morning. Of course, it will ring. So what we have to fill it with? The word rang. The school bell rang at 8 o'clock in the morning. After that, Ila is playing with her brother. Kairavi brought some delicious guavas for us today. My pet dog knows many tricks. See here, children, we have filled these blanks with the correct verbs and which are suitable in the blanks. After completing the chapter, we learnt about the chapter 4, articles. Children, in these articles, we learnt about three articles, a and the. Now, let us discuss in detail. See children, a and an are called articles. These are indefinite articles. Okay. We use a before words that began with a consonant. Or consonant sound. For example, after that we also use a before. That words begin with a vowel but have a consonant sound. For example, see here, mummy bought a uniform. Mummy bought a uniform at the shop. In this sentence, uniform will start with U, but it sounds like a consonant. So we have to use a here. An is used before words that begin with a vowel or vowel sound. For example, an elephant at the sanctuary. Take an umbrella with you as it might rain. In this sentence, umbrella. Umbrella also starts with U, but it sounds like vowel sound. So we are using an here. See here, children, I will show you one example here. In this exercise, we should tick the correct words in the brackets. They have provided two options. We have to tick the correct option here. Dash igloo is a house made of ice. A igloo or an igloo? Here, I sounds like vowel. It is a vowel and it sounds like vowel sound. So we have to use an igloo. You do know now how many vowels are there? A, E, I, O, U. Which word starts with these vowels? We should use always an only. And which words and which vowels also sound, but which vowels sound as consonant sounds, we should never use an. Okay? You should keep this point in your mind, children. Let us check the next one. My uncle has dash antique stone statue in his garden. Here we have used an here because the first letter A, it is belongs to vowel. So we are using an here. In the same manner, Dilip is training to become dash architect. Of course, an architect, because here the word starts with the vowel. In the same manner, let us check the next one. Mr. Gopalan is not dash unkind man, but he does have dash quick temper. Here, unkind, we are using you, but sometimes when it starts with you, we have to use a when it sounds like consonant. But here the sound as a vowel, so we have to use an. It is not a vowel, so we have to use a here. Now let us check the next one. Do you have dash iron pot that I can borrow? Here iron, but the word starts with vowel, so we have ticked here with the vowel. We have ticked the correct article here. Do you have to wear dash uniform at your place of work? Here its starting letter is vowel only, but it sounds when you pronounce it, when you read it, you have to read uniform. Uniform. So it changes the sound. So we have to tick A because it sounds like consonant sound. And let us check the next one. My mother is dash engineer. Here, engineer. The word starts with vowel, so we have to take the article an. And my father is dash professor. A professor and professor. Why we have ticked here? Yeah, because the word starts with consonant. So we have ticked here article A. We made birthday card, but we couldn't find envelope. Before the word birthday, we have to use A because it is a consonant sound and consonant word also. And here envelope. Envelope is the word which starts with vowel, so we have to use an. In the same manner, we have completed the remaining part also. After that, we have finished this exercise as a homework by using the correct articles a or an. Now let us know about definite article. We learned now about a and an as a indefinite article. Now we are going to learn about the is also an article. It is a definite article. The is used when we talk about a particular noun. For example, children, earth. Before the earth, we use usually the only, the earth. When we talk or when we use the particular nouns, we have to use article, that is which article? Definite article, that is the. The earth, the house on the corner, the boy I was talking to, the book on the table is mine. See, we are using article the when we are using particular nouns. The is also used when we talk about a kind of a class of nouns. For example, the French and the Italian teams are staying in this hotel. Here French particular team and here Italian also particular team. So we have used definite article to the in front of a particular noun. When we talk about a person, a place, an animal or a thing, for the first time we use a or an. When we are talking about for the first time or about a person, whether it is a place or animal or a thing, what we have to use? A or an when we use it for first time. However, when we talk about it again, we use a definite article when we are repeating it. Just remember, children, don't get confused, children. And the is also used before certain proper nouns such as rivers, mountains, oceans, buildings, books, newspapers and so on. For example, the Ganga, the Himalayas, the Indian Ocean. Now let us learn about pronouns. Children, pronouns. We should use these words. Let us revise this topic. Words that are used in the place of nouns are called pronouns. We use them to make sentences less repetitive. Some common pronouns are I, me, we, us, you, they, them, she, her, he, him and it. Now let us see few examples. Children, in this exercise we should select the correct pronouns from the options. See here, for example, Joy has left his sweater here. I will give it to Dash tomorrow in school. Of course, I will give it to him. Here we are not repeating the word Joy because in the place of Joy, we are using the word pronoun. Okay? Children, I hope we have done a good revision to make sure ourselves to attend the examination with confidence. Okay, children, don't get confusion by looking at the options. First, read the question properly and choose the correct option from the remaining options. Okay, children, and I wish you good luck. Let us meet in our next class. Thank you.